Okay, before we continue with our discussion on 6.4, let us do some recap on what we have discussed yesterday. Okay, first and foremost, we have talked about lens. Okay, anyone can share what is meant by lens? Anyone, boys and girls, what is lens refers to? Lens. Okay, anyone? You can open your mic or you can type on the in-call messages. Okay, so if possible, I hope you will be more active compared to yesterday. Okay, we have some answer from Ong Cheng and Nicholas here. At least one curved surface have lens axis which can refract or reflect light. Okay, so if you are asked to write a definition for lenses, remember students, lens is a, number one, lens is a transparent material. Okay, it is a transparent material with two surfaces where one of the surface must be a curve. Okay, so that is the definition for lens. I repeat, it is a transparent material with two surfaces where at least one of the surface must be a curve. Okay, so that is lens. Okay, then we also have discussed they are, how many types of lens do we have, students?
Two.
Yeah, we have two types of lenses. They are concave and convex lens. Okay, we have two types, concave and convex. And then we name these two lenses also as diverging and converging lens. So which one is diverging lens and which one is converging lens, students? Okay, which one is diverging lens? Which one is converging lens? Okay, anyone?
Convex is converging.
Yeah, very good. Okay, convex is a converging lens, while concave is a diverging lens. Okay, then we also have discussed the rules on drawing a ray diagram for lenses. So how many rules do we learn yesterday in drawing ray diagram for lenses, students? Oh, are you sure? How many rules? Are you sure, Sigwei? Okay, you can refer back to your module 6.3 or you can refer to your textbook. It is on page 254 in your textbook. Why so many? 8 rules. Rules is 3. There are 3 rules only. Okay, remember the 3 rules. What are they? First, if you are given lenses, either concave or convex lenses, let's say here you are given convex lens. Okay, and this is, let's say this is the focal point of the lens. Okay, let's say we place an object here. So the first rule, you can draw a ray diagram from the object passing through the optical center. Okay, this is the lens axis. Rule number one, we draw a ray diagram passing through the optical center. And what is going to happen to this ray? It will be undeviated, mean not refracted. So continue travel in a straight line. This is rule number one. Okay. The light can be coming from down here also if the object is here. Okay. Passing through the optical center. No reflection. Continue travel in a straight line. So this is the first rule. Okay. Second rule. The light ray from the object travel in a parallel line to the principal axis. And then for convex, it will be converged at the focal point here. Okay, this is your second rule. Okay, and then the third rule, the light ray from the object passing through the focal point. Okay, and it will be refract parallel to the principal axis. So this is rule number two, and this is rule number three. So there are 3 rules of constructing ray diagram for both concave and convex. And this one goes for concave. Okay, so this is the focal point. Draw another one here with the same distance. So let's say this is the object, and this is the axis of this lens. Optical center there. So the first rule, a light ray from the object passing through the optical center, no refraction. Okay, rule number one. Same with convex lens. Yeah, rule number two, a light ray travels straight to the principal, travel parallel to the principal axis. So where will it go? It will be diverged from the focal point at the front. It diverged. So this is the second rule. Okay. And then the third rule. Okay, the third rule, a ray from the object, okay, pass through the optical center, pass through the focal point. The focal point is there. This. So where will it go? It will be refract parallel to the principal axis. So these are the three rules of constructing ray diagram for both convex or concave. So not two, not eight, not six, but three. Yes.
Where is the image? Eh? It's for the concave lens.
Concave lens, the image is always here. For concave image is always appear here, where it is always virtual, upright, and diminished.
Okay. So many intersect point, oh.
Yeah.
There are so many intersect
points. This one, I just want to show you the three rules. Okay, later, if you want to know where is the formation of image, you can draw at least two of these three rules. Okay? Oh. Find the intersecting point.
Okay, okay.
Okay, here just now, I want to show you where is the three rules you can apply in drawing the ray diagram. Okay? It's a very good question. Okay, then also, students, we have determined the characteristic of image formed by lenses by drawing the ray diagram. Okay, and for convex lens, we can place the object in six different places. Okay, you can refer the table in your module or also in your textbook on page 256. Okay, where the object can be at the infinity. Okay, the object second, the object can be beyond 2F. Okay, the third position, the object is at 2F. Okay, and the fourth position, the object can be in between. Okay, I draw to you so you can see. I think it is more easy. Okay, let's say this is a convex lens. Again, this is the focal point. This is 2F. Okay, this is the focal point, 2F. Okay, let's say here is 2F. So first, the object can be at infinity. Okay, first position, U at infinity. Okay, second position, the object is here. Okay, U is beyond 2F. Okay, and the third position, the object can be placed at F. Okay, U equal 2F. And the fourth position, U is between F and 2F. Okay, object is between F and 2F. The fifth position, the object can be placed at the focal point. Okay, here U is equal to F. And the sixth position, the object can be placed here, which is very close to the lens, where U is less than F. Okay, so these are the six possible positions for placing the object in front of a convex lens. Okay, so at all these positions, you can draw, as I mentioned just now, you can draw two of the three rules in order to determine the characteristic of image. So where is the image formed? At the intersecting point of the two lines which you are draw. And for convex lens students, for each position of object, they will give you different characteristic of image. Okay, while for concave lens, it doesn't matter where you place the object as, the image is always formed in front of the lens with the characteristics of virtual, upright, and diminished. Okay, so actually this is just the first method for us to determine the characteristic of image by drawing ray diagrams. And today we are going to apply the second method, okay, to determine the characteristic of image for both convex and concave lenses. Okay, and also yesterday, student, we have learned about linear magnification. So what is linear magnification? It is a ratio, okay? A ratio of height of object to the, sorry, the ratio of height of image to the height of object, or it is the ratio of the image distance to the object distance. So linear magnification is a formula to determine either the image has been magnified being bigger size than the object, or either the image has been diminished being the size is smaller compared to the object, or either the image form has the same size with the object. Okay, so they will give you three values if you use this formula. Okay, number one, it can be possible m later less than one. So if you get m less than one, it means that the object has the image has been what, students? Later when you apply, so yes, the image has been diminished, or the size of the image is smaller compared to the object. And if you have m exactly equal to one, so what does it mean? M equal to one, both image and object has the same size. Okay, and later if you have the linear magnification m greater than one, so it shows to us, yes, that the image has been magnified. Magnified means it has a bigger size compared to the object. Okay, and last but not least, I have discussed with you how to determine power of lens. Okay, so it can be determined from this formula. P is power, measured in a unit of, what is the unit for power? Who remember? Okay, power, the unit is in diopter, capital D. Okay, so this is the formula. Power is equal to the reciprocal of F, okay, where power is inversely proportional to the focal length. Okay, means when the focal length is shorter, the power is higher. Okay, and for convex lens, okay, a thicker lens has a shorter focal length and high power. Okay, meanwhile, for concave lens, a thinner concave lens has a shorter focal length and has a high power. Okay, so I hope you are clear with our discussion on 6.3. So these are all the gist of the content standard. So I hope you get all these 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7. Okay, so another one, this is the correction on one of the exercises I gave you yesterday. I'm sorry that I just noticed when we end our lesson, because the actual question is on curved mirror. Okay, curved mirror we will learn in 6.6, students. So I have changed the question, so make it under curved lens. So this is the correction I hope you can make. Okay, you are given diagram 7 shows a boy with his image in a plane mirror. Okay, so this is a mirror, and then later we took out this mirror, we change it with curved lens. Okay, and it tells you here which pair is correct to produce virtual, magnified, and upright image if the plane mirror is now replaced with a curved lens. So this is the correction which I made, and this is another correction here, the type of lens, okay, not type of mirror. And here is the position of the boy labeled with U. U is object distance, okay, and focal length of the lens labeled with F. Okay, so if you remember yesterday, which position of object for convex lens will give you this characteristic, okay, virtual, magnified, and upright. So actually there are two positions. Okay, there are two positions where you can have a characteristic of virtual, magnified, and upright for convex mirror, for convex lens, sorry. So this one is the first position where U is placed at F. Okay, so it will give you a virtual, upright, and magnified image where the image is formed at infinity. Okay, and the second position, the object is placed less than the focal length. Okay, where it also produces virtual, upright, and magnified image. Okay, so which one we have here? As you can see in the option, so we can reject concave. Okay, we can reject concave lens because concave lens always give you virtual, upright, diminished. Okay, this one you can keep in your mind. Concave lens always give you virtual, upright, diminished image. Okay, so we have two choices. So either A, U greater than F, or B, U less than F. So here we see U less than F. So the answer is boy. Yes, very good, Nicholas. So I have made a correction on this question, on both question and answer. Okay, so I hope you're clear with that. Okay, students, so let us now continue with the next content standard 6.4. This is lens formula. Okay, Lang's formula means there are one mathematical formula you have to apply here in order to determine the characteristic of image formed by convex and concave lenses. Remember, there are two methods you can apply to determine characteristic of image. The first method is by drawing ray diagram. Okay, so these are the second method on applying lens formula. Okay, so for this content standard, it is very short. It has two learning standards only, okay, 6.4.1 and 6.4.2. So let us take a look at the first learning standard, 6.4.1, as you can read on my screen now. In this learning standard, there is one activity or experiment which can be conducted, okay, in order to investigate the relationship between object distance U and image distance B for a convex lens. Mean what happened to the image distance when the object distance changes. Okay. Then second, the same experiment is also to determine focal length of a thin lens using lens. So this is lens formula. 1 over F equal 1 over U plus 1 over V. So I hope you all familiar what is this F, what is this U, and what is this V refers to. So F is the focal length, U is the object distance, and V is the image distance. Okay. So before we take a look at this experiment, okay, let us look at these two diagrams. Okay, if you look at the first diagram, diagram A, it shows an image for different object distance taken with a camera lens of the same focal length. Okay. So we place the object at different distance. Okay, the first one, okay, if you look at the diagram on the left, okay, so this is the focal length. 24 mm in it refers to the focal length of the camera. Okay, so this one also, the focal length is 24 mm. Okay, V focal length is what? Focal length is what? Focal length, this is the terminology. Focal length is the distance between the focal point and the optical center of the lens. Okay. For this one, we place the camera at this distance, 0.5 feet. Okay, so this will give you the object distance. Okay, we place the object 0.5 feet from the lens. Okay, and for this one, we place the object at 1 feet. So this is the distance is further. Okay, 1 feet. We place the car 1 feet away from our camera lens. Okay, so what is the, this is the picture taken, okay, at this distance. And this is the picture taken at this distance of 1 feet. Okay, you can see here. Okay, what can you say about the size of image, students? Okay, it is obviously that which one is bigger? Definitely this one, right? But the size of the image here when the object distance is less is bigger. So you write here short distance. For short object distance, it produces a large image. Okay. Meanwhile, for a long object distance, mean the object is put further away from the lens, so it will produce smaller image. Okay. Inversely, yes, in way inversely. Okay, then. So from here, what is the relationship between object distance and image distance? It can be conclude later on from this formula. Okay, 1 over F equal 1 over U plus 1 over B. Okay, as for object distance and image size of image, it is inversely proportional. All right. Okay, second case, okay, case B. Okay, now what is the difference between these two pictures? Okay, before that, if you look at the title up there, this is the image taken for the same object distance. Okay, now the object distance is the same, but the difference is in the focal length of the camera. Okay, here the focal length is 24 mm. Okay, and here the focal length is longer, 60 mm. Okay, so object distance is the same, u1 equal to u2. Okay, so this one, you look at the first picture on the left. when the focal length is shorter, the image produced is smaller. Okay? And here, when the focal length is longer, you can see that the image produced is larger. So what is the relationship between size of image and focal length here? Zoom in, greater image, zoom out, smaller image, Nicholas. Okay, so what is the relationship between focal length and size of image here? You can see that it is directly proportional, right? When the focal length is longer, yes, the size of image is greater. Okay, just now, in the case A, we look at the relationship between object distance and size of image. Okay, so when object distance is shorter, size of image is bigger. So it is inversely proportional. For this one, is directly proportional. Okay, focal length longer, size of image bigger. Okay. And this is another example shows to you a different image for the same object distance, which took with a camera lens of a different focal length. Okay, so you can see that when the focal length is longer, the image produced is greater. Okay, this one also the same. The focal length increases from 50 to 70 to 85, and you can see that the size of image is increases. Okay, this one also the same. From 135 to 200 to 400, when the focal length is greater, so the size of image is bigger. So it shows to us F is directly proportional to the size of image. Okay. Okay, so now that is to open your mind, what is the relationship between U, V, and F? So now by experiments, this one you can find in your textbook on page 259. Okay, experiment 6.3, 259, 259. Okay. And this is the inference for this experiment. Remember, students, how to write an inference in your experimental report. Inference is writing in this way. This one is RV. Okay, RV is influenced by MV. Okay, RV is affected by MV. Okay, so image distance is influenced by the object distance. The image distance is affected by the object distance. Okay, and this is the hypothesis, means the earlier prediction we make before we conduct the experiment. That is hypothesis. Okay, so the hypothesis, when the object distance increases, we predict that when the object distance increases, the image distance decreases. Okay, and this is the aim for this experiment. Number one is to study what is the relationship between object distance and image distance for convex lens. And second is to determine the focal length of a lens using lens formula. Okay. And these are all the apparatus and material required for this experiment. Again, you can find this diagram in your textbook on page 260. Okay. We need a convex lens with a focal length of 10 centimeters. This is the lens holder, bulb to produce the light sources, a wooden block to support, white screen to produce the image, okay, to project the image at. And also meter rule, this is to measure the object distance and to measure the image distance, V. So what is the manipulated variable here, students? Okay, what is the manipulated variable here? So from the hypothesis and inference just now, our MV is the object distance. Okay, object distance. Okay. How can I know my focal length when I'm using phone camera? Your phone camera, if you look at your phone camera, there are multiple camera there. Okay. And each camera, it has a different focal length. Okay. I don't know what is the focal length. Maybe you can find on the description on your manual of your phone. It might be written there. Okay, you can go and check. Okay, if you have 5 cameras in your phone, each camera has a different focal length. Okay, so when you took a picture where the object in front has a different distance, so it will be, it can take accordingly. So whatever why our phone camera consists of, normally our phone camera consists of more than one camera. So this is to make the photograph to be, what to say, more accurate. Meaning when you take the picture, they will be in the exact position. Okay, Nicholas. I don't know how to determine the focal length. So I think it was written in the manual or the description of your phone. So you can check from there. Okay. Because different phone, they have different focal length. Okay. Different brand, different design, and so on. Okay. Our RV here, students. Our RV is image distance, D. Okay. Can you guess what is our fixed variable here? Our MB is U, our RV is B, image distance. So can you guess what is the fixed variable or the constant variable? Anyone? It is, not the widescreen position. That will be changes later on. You will adjust the widescreen position is actually represent the image distance. Yes, it is focal length. Okay, the focal length means we are using the convex lens with the same thickness all the time. Okay, so we fix the focal length. We are using identical lenses all along this experiment. Okay? Okay, and this is the procedure. It's a very short and simple procedure. First, we have to switch on the bulb. Before that, we have to arrange them as shown in the diagram. Adjust the position of the lens and make it at a distance of 15 cm from the light sources. Okay, so this will be our object distance. And then later, when you turn on the bulb, you have to adjust the screen in order to form a sharp image. So we have to move the screen front and back. You will stop when you get a sharp image produced on it. Okay, so that will give you the image distance. Okay, and we repeat this experiment for different object distance of 20, 25, 30 cm and 35 cm. Okay, and this is the find out from this experiment, students. So this is the different position of object. We started with 15, ended with 35, and this is the image distance. Okay, so you can fill up your table with this value. And later we count for this 1 over U and 1 over B. Okay, so just press your calculator and determine all the values. Okay, so 1 over U is 1 over 15. It gives you 0.067. So this one, 1 over 30, give you 0.033 and so on. Okay, so you can fill up your table with all these values. So if you see my reading, all are consistent in 2, in 3 decimal places. Okay, if you want to put in 2 decimal places, so put them all in 2 decimal places as well. So this will be 0.07, 0.05, 0.04, 0.03, 0.03. All right, okay. So this is the simple animation shows to you how V changes when U changes. Okay, here you can see the object is bring closer to the lenses. And you can see that the distance of image will be further. Okay, when the object of distance is shorter, the image distance is longer. So from here, what can we say? So this is the analysis. Okay, the analysis from our data on the table. So we plot a graph of 1 over V against 1 over U. So this is graph of 1 over V against 1 over U. Okay, 1 over V against mean this should be in Y axis. Okay, Y against X. So 1 over U must be in the X axis. Okay, and this is all the point we mark on our graph. So this is the best fit line. Okay, the best fit line we can get. And the triangle shows to you how to find the gradient. Okay, so how to find the gradient of the graph. So these are the 2 points on this line. Okay, these are the 2 points. So this point, can you tell me what is the coordinate for this point? The first point, students, what is the coordinate? I zoom it for you so easy for you to see. Okay, what is the coordinate of the first point? Oh, I cannot see down there. Okay, so this is point 0.03, 0.07. Okay, this is the first point. Okay, and this is the coordinate for the second point. It is 0.07. And on the y-axis is 0.03. Okay. So how to find the gradient? The gradient, remember what is the formula to find gradient? Y2 minus y1 divide x2 minus x1. Okay, y2 minus y1 divide x2 minus x1. So this is x1, this is y1, this is x2, this is y2. Okay, so y2 0.03 minus y1 0.07. Divide x2. x2 is 0.07 minus x1, 0.03. So can you find what is the gradient of this graph? Please solve for this. Okay, what is the gradient shows here, students? Okay, press your calculator and share to us the answer. So it will be, anybody's counting?
Negative 1,
thank you, Ong Zeng. So it will be -1, okay? You look at the grade, you look at this slide, you know this graph has a negative gradient. So it is -1, okay? And from here, what else can we have? So from the Lenz formula, so from this formula, 1 over F equal to 1 over U plus 1 over V, okay? And according to this formula, can you tell me what formula is this? Y equal to MX plus C? What formula is this? Y equal to mx plus c, students?
Linear equation.
This is linear equation, straight line formula. Okay, straight line or linear equation formula. So how to equalize the Lenz formula and the linear equation formula? Okay, from this graph, which one represented y? So we have three. We have three values here. 1 over u, then we have 1 over v, and we have 1 over v. So which one represent y? Which one represent x? Which one represent the intercept c? M is -1, the gradient. Okay? So when we rearrange this, so from the graph, you can see that on the y-axis is 1 over v, right? So this one, okay? 1 over v represent y. Okay? M gradient is -1. And from here, what is our x-axis? Our x-axis is 1 over u. So this one, 1 over u, which means that the intercept is 1 over f. So where is the intercept? This is the intercept, okay, the y-intercept. AC is y-intercept. So y-intercept is 1 over f, okay? And if you write here the x-intercept of this graph, x-intercept is here, 0.1, okay? And the y-intercept, which is also 1 over f, is 0.1 also, shows up there. So from the y-intercept, we can find the focal length. Okay, so if 1 over f is 0.1, which means f is 10 centimeters. So from this graph, the focal length of the lens is 10 centimeters. Okay, are you clear with this? How we end up with focal length 10 centimeters? Okay. Any question on this graph? No question, silence. Okay, so let us move to the next slide. Okay, so from this graph, we have plot a graph of 1 over V against 1 over U. This is the conclusion that we can make. Number one, the graph shows that 1 over V decreases linearly. Remember, we learned how to analyze this graph in the first chapter. So when you are given this line, it shows that 1 over V decreases linearly with 1 over U, which means the object distance increases, image distance decreases. So inversely proportional. Okay, so our hypothesis is accepted. Okay, when object distance increases, image distance decreases, and vice versa. Okay, students? Okay, next. Okay, this is the safety precaution you can take when conducting these two experiments. Okay, can you guess the first safety precaution? the first safety precaution, we always write how to gain the reading. Okay, first and foremost, your eye position, okay, must be perpendicular to the scale or meter rule. Okay, when taking reading, this is to avoid parallax error. Why meter rule here? Because we are using meter rule to determine our responding variable. If you are using stopwatch to determine your responding variable, then you must write eye position perpendicular to the scale of stopwatch. Okay, if you're taking a reading of a current, so eye position must be perpendicular to the scale of ammeter, or eye position perpendicular to the scale of thermometer if you are taking temperature. Okay, so always mention what is the devices you are using to determine the responding variable. Okay, so here eye position perpendicular to the scale of meter rule when taking reading to avoid parallax error. And then there is a second safety precaution for this experiment. It must be conducted in a dark room condition. Okay, so later it will be easy for you to observe where is the position of the image as shown here in this animation. Okay, so this is how we adjust the screen until we get a sharp image. Okay, so the distance from the lens to the screen will give you the image distance. Okay, and the distance of the candle from the lens is giving you the object distance. Okay, so I hope you are clear with this experiment. Any question on it? Before we move to this example, nothing difficult, right? Okay, so students, let us take a look at one example of question here. They give you a convex lens. Okay, they give you a convex lens. It shows a diagram for an image. So this is the image I formed by an object O. So this is the object O. Okay, placed at a distance of 15 cm. So the object is placed at a distance of 15 cm, which means this is the object distance in front of the convex lens. So first and foremost, again, name the light phenomenon involved. So what is the light phenomenon involving lenses? Yes, very good. It is refraction of light. Okay. Okay, and then next. Okay, next. Okay, we have to calculate. You have to determine what is the focal length of this lens. Okay, students, what is the focal length of this convex lens? You are given U of 15, and this is the distance between the object and the image. So can you find F? How to find F? And then later, find the height of the image if the height of the object is 1.2 cm. 60. 60. 60 minus, what is it? So this is the information you are given. Okay, this is the U, this is the object distance, 15 cm. Okay, and this is the image distance. So how to find image distance? It is 75. Okay, 75 minus 15. Yeah, V can be negative. Later on, I will tell you what is the what is the difference between positive and negative sign here. Okay, later in the next part. Okay, so here we have 60 cm. Okay, then this is the formula to apply in order to determine the focal length. Lens formula, 1 over F equal 1 over U plus 1 over V. So we just do the substitution. Okay, so U is 15. V is 60. So 1 over F is 1 over 12, which means the focal length is 12 centimeter. Okay, later on I'll explain to you why I put positive sign here. Okay, so answer is 12 centimeter, the focal length. Okay, can you find number two? Find the height of image is given the height of object is 1.2 cm. Okay, students. Okay, so this one you apply the formula we learned yesterday. Okay, so what is the formula? They give you height of object 1.2 cm. You can find the height of image by applying this linear magnification equation. Okay, HI divide HO equal to V divide U. Okay, V is image distance, U is object distance. So we do the substitution. height of object 1.2, image distance is 60, object distance is 15. So this will give you height of object of 4.8 centimeter. Okay, so the answer is 4.8 cm. All right. Okay, next, okay, question C. Okay, you have to predict what will happen to the image form when the object is moved closer to the lens until it is at a distance equal to the focal length of the lenses. Okay, so what happened? What do you think will happen, student, if we bring the object closer and closer towards the lenses? Okay, so what will happen to the image form? Okay, any idea? Any idea what happened to the image form when the object is moved closer? It means is the size of image is going to increase or decrease, or what happened to the image distance, increase or decrease? Okay, so that is the prediction you can make. Okay, so I show you the simulation to give you some idea. So the red bar is our object. Okay, we move it closer to the image. We move it closer to the lenses. So you can see as we move it closer to the lenses, the image distance is increases. Okay, so this one is what we can write. Okay, number one, you can say the image form is real, inverted, magnified, and distance of image increases. Okay, and getting further from the lenses. So this is what happens when we bring the object closer to the lenses. The image form will be real, mean form at the opposite side. It is inverted as you can show here, and it is magnified. Okay, and the distance will be increases further from the lenses. And then here the second, when U equal to F. Okay, when U equal to F, so what happened now? The image will form at this side. It is virtual, upright, and magnified, and it is formed at infinity. Okay, and when you bring it more closer to the surface, more closer to the lens, so what happened? The image is virtual, upright, and also magnified. Okay, and it formed here, this one. Okay, this is the final position. Okay, it is formed in between F and 2F. So this one you can refer back to the table. Okay, what happened to the characteristic of image when we change the position of the object in front of a convex lens? Okay, so these are the two possibilities which might happen. Okay, when we change the position of the object, we bring it closer to the lenses until the distance U equal to F. Okay? Okay, then that is to do with the first learning standard. Okay, how to apply lens formula in order to determine the characteristic of image. Okay, now this is the second learning standard, solving a problem using lens formula for both convex and concave lenses. So are you ready to solve problems here, students, boys and girls? So before we try to solve the problem, this is the very important sign convention which we are going to use in a lens formula. Okay, the first one. Okay, we have two parameters here. The first one is focal length. Second is the image distance. And here is the positive sign, negative sign. Okay, students, first, the first parameter, focal length. Okay, we have two lenses, right? We have convex and concave lenses. Okay, for convex lens, the focal length, it has positive sign. Okay, for convex lens, the focal length has a positive sign. Positive sign means it has a real focal length. Okay, and then for concave lens, the focal length has a negative sign. Okay, it has a negative sign, means it has a virtual focal length. The focal length is in front, okay, for concave. And for convex lens, the focal length is behind, right? So it is positive. Okay, for example, when they give you a question, convex lens, so later you have to place positive sign. Okay, let's say the focal length in the question is given 20 cm. Okay, mean later when you solve a problem, you must put positive sign in front of 20 cm. Okay, and let's say in the question, they give you concave lens. And they mention in the question, the focal length of the concave lens is 10 cm. Okay, so when you apply the formula, you must put negative in front of 10 cm for concave. Okay, they won't give you directly the positive and negative sign in the question. You yourself must edit. Okay, so you must know for convex, we put positive in the focal length. And for concave, we put negative in front of the focal length. Okay, and second, image distance. Okay, image distance. So later when you apply this formula, yeah, must involve. Okay. So later when you apply this formula and you find, later when you find the value for negative is, the value for V, you find the value is positive. Okay. So positive value for V, what does it mean? It means that the image form is real. Okay. Real means it form on the opposite side of the object. Okay. And when you do calculation and somehow you find the V is negative. Okay, you make a calculation and finally you find V is, let's say, negative 30 cm. Okay, so this negative 30 cm shows what? It shows that the image produced is virtual. Okay, virtual means the image produced on the same side as the object. Okay, again, when you find V is positive, let's say positive 15 cm. So it means the image produced is real image. Okay, real mean opposite side of the object, 15 centimeter away from the lens. Okay, 15 centimeter behind the lens. This one, the image form 30 centimeter in front of the lens at the same position with the object. Okay, this one, image form at the opposite side of the object at a distance 15 centimeter away from the lenses. So remember, this is a very important sign convention. Positive focal length shows convex lens. Negative focal length refers to concave lens. Positive image distance shows the image is real. Negative image distance shows the image is virtual. Okay, let us apply in this next question. Okay, before that, this is some animation on image formation for both convex and concave lenses. Okay, you can see how the image changes in position when we change the object position. Okay, and here for concave lens, the image always forms here. Virtual, upright, diminished, right? Okay. So here it says position characteristic of image varies with object distance for convex lens. Meanwhile, for concave lens, the position and characteristic of image always virtual, upright, and diminished. Okay, now let us try your understanding by take a look at this first question. Okay, we have an object placed 30 centimeters from a convex lens, as you can see in this diagram. Okay, the focal length of this lens is given 20 cm. Okay, so the question, how far from the lens is the image? Okay, student, so what are we going to find here? How far from the lens is the image? We are looking for what? Can you give me the symbol we are looking for here? How far from the lens is the image? What are we looking for in question 1A? Yes, Koja, very good. We are looking for V, image distance. So what is the information you are given? So first, you can write, okay, you are given convex lens, okay? So convex lens, okay, U is positive, okay? For object distance, it's positive for both, okay? For convex and concave, object distance is positive for both, okay? The object is always placed in front of the mirror, in front of the lens, sorry. So it is positive, okay? And here, it gives you 20 cm, okay? 20 cm. So we plus positive, why? Because it is a convex lens. Okay, convex lens has a positive focal length. So this is the formula we are going to apply. So you just do the substitution. Okay, 1 over F is 1 over 20. You can paste the positive there. I forgot to put it. Okay, so this is U, 1 over 30. So 1 over B. So we are looking for 1 over B. Can you find what is 1 over B? Or find B. Okay, cuba kira berapa the image distance. I give you some time to figure out the answer before I share to you mine. Okay, I hope you're working on this. Take your calculator, find what is the image distance. We are looking in this question 1A. Nicholas, 1 over 60. Okay, 1 over 60. And so 1 over 60 is 1 over V. Okay, so we are looking for V, which means V is positive 60 cm. Okay, positive 60 cm means what? The image is located 60 centimeter from the optical center. This one, okay? 60 centimeter from the optical center. And it is on the opposite side of the object. Okay, which means the image is real. Okay, remember just now, positive means the image produced is real. Okay? Second, okay, now try B. What is the magnification produced by the lens? Okay, now find the magnification. We learned yesterday how to find magnification. So can you find? And later in C, what is the characteristic of the image formed? So this is our object. Okay, this is our image. Okay, so what is the magnification produced, students? So magnification M is image distance divide object distance. So just now image distance is 60, object distance is 30. So magnification is 2. So magnification greater than 1, it means our image has been magnified. Okay, image magnified. It magnified, it has double size compared to the object. So what is the characteristic? It is real, inverted, and magnified. Okay, real, why real? Form at the opposite side. Okay, why inverted? Form below the principal axis. And magnified, you can see from the diagram, it has been, it is bigger compared to the object. And from here, we have proof the image has been magnified, where M greater than 1. Okay, yeah, magnification have no unit, just write 2. Okay, then number 2. Okay, we move to question 2. Okay, now we have concave lens, as you can see in the diagram. An object is placed 30 centimeter from a concave lens with a focal length of 20 cm. Okay, no problem, Xinwei. Later you can check on the recording. All right. Okay, thank you for being here. Okay, so 2A, how far from the lens is the image? Again, we are using, we are looking for image distance. So what is the image distance, students? Okay, find the image distance. Why I highlight concave lens here? Because later on, it is very important for you to place positive or negative sign on the focal length. So you know it is a concave lens, which means you must put negative sign in front of this 20 cm. Okay, so what is the V now here in 2A? Plus got negative 60. Let us check. Okay, so this is the information. Object distance is 30 cm and F is negative 20 cm. Why negative? Concave lens. Okay, so this is the formula we are applying. So this is the substitution. You must place negative there. Negative 1 over 20. Okay. This one is the object distance 1 over U. So we are looking for this V. Okay. I see just now for both concave and convex, image distance is always positive. Okay. U is always negative. U is always positive for both lenses, convex and concave. Okay, U always positive, object distance always positive, okay, as we place the object in front of the lenses. And then So this is the substitution. Yeah, F depend on lenses. Yes, F positive for convex and negative for concave. Okay, and V determine either the object, either the image is real or negative is real, negative means virtual. All right. Okay, so from here, 1 over V is negative 5 over 60. Okay, so this is not the answer because we are looking for V. So V is negative 12. Okay, V is negative 12 centimeters. And again, negative sign shows what? The image is located at 12 centimeters from the optical center on the same side of the object. So you can see from the diagram, the object is in front of the lens. Image also formed at the same side in front of the lens. So it is virtual. Negative sign show the image is virtual on the same side. Okay. And what is the characteristic of the image? Can you, from this diagram, can you write the characteristic of this image? Number one, we know it is virtual from this calculation, V negative. And then how about the size? You can see the size is smaller. Okay, and you can see it is upright. Okay, upright. So before we write the characteristic, we count first. What is the magnification produced by these lenses? Okay, again, we apply M equal V divide U. Okay, so the magnification is 0.4. Okay, so student, for magnification, since it is a ratio, okay, so for magnification, you don't have to put any positive or negative sign there for magnification, okay, since it is a ratio. So positive and negative sign is ignored. So you will find the value less than 1. So it shows that our image has been diminished. Okay. So the characteristic, yes, VUD, not VUR, virtual, upright, diminished, VUD. Right? Okay. Next, okay, try question number 3, students. Again, you're using, you're given concave lens with a focal length 25 cm. It forms a virtual image, A of an N, at a distance of 20 cm from the optical center of the lens. So they tell you already, the image form is virtual. A focal length is 25 cm. Okay, so the image form 20 cm from the optical center. So the first question, what is the original position of the end? Okay, what is the original position of the end? So what are we looking for in question 3A? Original position represented by U. Yes, very good. So what is U? Can you find U? They give you F, they give you V, so from there you can find U, okay? Okay, everyone, please working on this. What is the original position of the end? Okay, I'll give you a few seconds, a few minutes to figure out. Can Nicholas say 100? How about the rest of you? What do you get? Okay, you can share your answer in the in-call messages. Negative 100. Okay, so this is the formula and this is the information you are given. So now you are given concave lens, right? So concave lens, F is negative 25. Okay, V, why negative? Because it shows virtual image. So virtual image, negative 20 cm. Okay, so we do the substitution. So this is 1 over F, negative. This is 1 over U and this is V, negative there. And negative 1 over 20. All right. So by this, U is 100 centimeter or positive 100 centimeter. As I mentioned, U is always positive. Okay. U is always positive for both lenses, concave or convex. So this shows to us that the end is 100 centimeter in front of the convex, concave lens. Okay, yeah. Yeah, you should be always positive. And okay, now you will remember. Okay, so B, Now we have to draw the ray diagram to show the formation of a virtual image of the end. So how to draw a ray diagram? So first you draw the principal axis, the blue line here, and then you draw the concave lens. So this is the symbol for concave lens. Okay, you can draw the real lens or you just show this symbol, it shows a concave lens. Okay, while for convex lens, this is the symbol, convex. Okay, so kalau you sambung dia jadi macam inilah, convex. Okay, this one is concave. Like this is concave. So kalau you sambung, it become like this, concave. The shape. Alright, okay. So this is concave lens. So where object is 100 centimeter. Okay, so you draw exactly at 100 centimeter as shown here. This is our object. Okay, then where is our image? Our image is 20 centimeters. So 20 centimeter virtual, same side. So here is our image. Okay, and then you can draw the ray diagram. So this one follow rule number one. Okay, a light from the object passing through the optical center, so it does not refract. Okay, and this is the second rule. A straight line parallel to the principal axis diverge from the focal point at the front. So it intersects here, so exactly where our image from actual, upright, and diminished. All right? Okay. Okay, now move to question four. Okay, question four again, you are given convex lens, okay, with a focal length of 6 centimeter. And given the height of the object is 2 centimeter. Now they give you the height of object, 2 centimeter. Okay, and from the question, you can see that the object distance is 9. Okay, it's shown here. So this is where our image is from at the opposite side below the principal axis. Okay, so you have to find the image distance. Okay, students, we are looking for V. How to find V here? Okay, again, so this is the information you are given. U is 9 centimeter, always positive. F, positive 6. Y, positive, convex lens. Okay. And this is the equation. Third step, substitution. Okay, substitution. Okay, then you will find V is positive 18 cm. Okay, positive 18 cm means our image is from 18 centimeter on the opposite side. Okay, from the optical center. Okay, then find the height of image. Okay, fine. Height of image. Okay, Bong Yi Eun, Eric, Ru Eun, Yan Xin, Xiu Qing, Jun Chuan. Okay, we still have Pui Xin here, Jia Yi, Qin Xia. We have 25 so far. Okay. Okay, Hong Zhe, can you find the height of image? Wan Jia, what do you get? Height of image. Is this one, you want to share your answer? Yu Hui, what about you? Manting, what is the height of the image? Is it the height of the image? So what is it, Nicholas? 4. Okay. So what is the height of the image? Let us take a look at the solution. So this is a formula you can apply to find the height of image from linear magnification. Height of image divide height of object equal to image distance divide object distance. Okay, but this is the substitution. Object height is 2 cm. It is stated in the question. Okay, this one you can highlight. Okay, then image distance we count earlier, it is 18, and in object distance is 2, so this will give you 4 centimeter. Okay, the height of image is 4 centimeter. Very simple, right? Okay, now next question. This is an objective question. Okay, you are given diagram A and diagram B. Diagram A shows the arrangement of apparatus to determine the relationship of U and V as in experiment 6.3 earlier. Okay, and the focal length of a convex lens. So this is the graph shows to you the result. of this experiment. Okay, a graph of 1 over V against 1 over U shows a negative gradient. So what is the value for Q, students? What is the value for Q here? So Q in here shows what? Is it A, 1 over F? Is it B, 1 over U? Or is it C, F, the focal point? Or is it D, U over V? So it is, remember here is the y-intercept. Okay, so y-intercept is 1 over F. Okay, this one, C. Here this point is C, y-intercept. So it is 1 over F, the reciprocal of F. Okay, very good. Answer is A. Okay, now move to question 6. Okay, question 6, what do you say? We have figure 6.1. It shows an image of the letter fizzy. It shows here fizzy when viewed through a glass of water. So this is the book cover. We view through a glass of water. So this is how the letter appear, fizzy. K is gone. Okay. So the first question, state the light phenomenon that causes the image fizzy to be enlarged. Again, they're asking for phenomenon. So it should be, without no hesitation, it is refraction. Okay, refraction, or you can say refraction of light. Okay, refraction itself is enough. And then B, what is the change of size of the image if the water is replaced with a transparent liquid of a greater optical density? Okay, can you give one example of liquid which has a greater optical density compared to water? So the water here can be replaced with an oil. Okay, we can replace the water with an oil, olive oil. Okay, what do you think will happen to the size of the image? Size, they are talking about size, Nicholas, size. Okay, for size, you must mention either the size increases, become bigger, or decreases, become smaller, or it has the same size as before. Which one? Okay, read the question carefully. Size, so you have to mention become bigger, become smaller, or no changes at all. So what do you think? Liquid of greater optical density. Okay. Who said the size is bigger? Who says the size of image becomes smaller? Who say no changes? Answer, no changes will be definitely wrong. Okay. When you change the medium in a different optical density, so the degree of bending of light will be different. But there must be a difference in size. So it will be increases. Okay. Size of image will be increases. It will be enlarged, okay, in a high optical density medium. All right? Okay. Then C. Okay, this one is a calculation. Okay. The glass of the water is replaced with the lens. And now we replace the water with lens. Lens M with a focal length of 10 cm. Okay. Distance between the book cover and the optical center of the lens is 8 cm. It is observed that the image fizzy is enlarged. Okay, so this is a very important information you are given. So first, name the type of lens M. So what is lens M? Convex or concave? Okay, this is the information, lens M, focal length, 10 cm. Okay, they give you the distance between the book cover and optical center is 8 cm. It is observed that image fizzy is enlarged. Okay, so lens M must be concave or convex, students. It cannot be concave, right? Why it cannot be concave? Because remember, for concave, the image is always virtual, upright, diminished. Okay, so there is no way it's going to enlarge. So this is not concave lens. It must be convex lens. Okay, lens M is a convex lens. This is the hint, enlarge. Okay. And now, second question, find the distance of the image from lens M. So, which means, what is B? Okay, can you find B? This is what we do earlier. Okay, using the lens formula to find the image distance. Okay, so you just list out all the information given. U is 8 centimeter here. Okay, distance between the book cover and the optical center will give you object distance U of 8 centimeter. Okay, focal length is positive. Why positive? Convex lens. 10 cm is given here. Okay, so we are looking for V, image distance. Again, this is the formula. We just do the substitution. Okay, and you will end up with negative 40 cm. Okay, so negative 40 cm means what? So negative 40 cm means the image is virtual. 40 centimeter in front of the lenses at the same side with the object. Okay? Image is located 40 centimeter from the optical center on the same side. So on the same side is virtual. Okay? And number three, determine the linear magnification. Okay, what is the linear magnification, students? Again, for linear magnification, you can apply the linear magnification formula, M equal V divide U. Okay, so V is 40, U is 8. As I mentioned, to find linear magnification, we ignore the positive and negative signs since linear magnification is a ratio. Okay, so the linear magnification is 5. 5 means the image has been enlarged 5 times bigger compared to the object. Okay, so are you clear with this question? Question 6, this is SPM past year question. Okay, question 6 is an SPM past year question on lenses. All right. Okay, so I think that's all for today. We finished a bit earlier today because it's a very short topics. So do you have any further question before we dismiss? Show you again the last slide. Okay. So 6.4 lens formula, 1 over F equal 1 over U plus 1 over V. So I hope you can do more exercises on this to familiar yourself, especially with the positive and negative sign for convex and concave lenses. Okay, so can you please go to your workbook now? Please open or turn to page. So in your workbook, thin lens formula will start from page 185. Okay, 185. Okay, can we try a few questions since we have a few more minutes left before 11:30 a.m.? Can you go to your workbook, page 186? 186, students. 186. Okay, can you go there on page 186? Are you there? Okay, so we have 4 questions there. Can you choose one question to discuss? Okay, I choose for you. Okay, can you try to do question number 1? Okay, uji kendiri 6.4. In 1 minute, okay, try to find what is the image distance and magnification of image, and also state the characteristic of the image form when you are given an object which is placed 25 cm from a concave lens with a focal length of 15 cm. Okay, you can look at your workbook, page 186, question number 1, uji kendiri 6.4. Okay. Please try to work on it. So in question 1, Okay, you are given a concave lens. I wrote you the lens. Let's say this is the concave lens. We are given with I guess it's the symbol. Okay, this is the symbol for concave lens. Okay, give you a concave lens with a focal length of 15 cm. So it has a focal length of 15 cm. This is focal length 15 cm. Okay, an object is placed 25 cm from the concave lens. So this is where we place the object. Let's say the object is placed here at a distance of 25 cm, AU 25 cm. Okay, so find the image distance and second find the magnification of image. So for concave lens, the image is always formed somewhere here, okay, between the optical lenses and the focal point. This is our object. Let's say this is the image form, okay. So find V, students. So what is V? A question mark there. Okay, have you figured out what is V? So for A, what is the information you are given? First, you are given with U. U is always positive, so 25 cm. Okay, and the focal length. Okay, remember, focal length for concave lens is negative, so it is negative 15 cm. Okay, so we are looking for image distance. Okay, so this is the second step. You write the formula you are going to apply, 1 over F equal to 1 over U. Okay, plus 1 over B. Okay, so you just do the substitution. F is negative 15. U is positive. Positive, if you didn't write, still okay. Okay, but negative, you must put in the 1 over B. Okay, try to solve this. So 1 over B will be 1 over negative 15 plus, sorry, minus is 1 minus. Okay. Minus 1 over 25. So V will be, so solve this, what is the value you get? 1 over 15 minus 1 over 25. So you solve for this, later you will get V will be equal to, anybody come up with the answer? Negative, yes, the value for B will be negative. So what is the value? B is negative what? Okay, negative. Okay, fine then. Don't give the answer in fraction. Remember another thing in physics, never leave your answer in fraction. It is a total error. Okay? Because 8 divided 75 still can be solved. Okay. So B is anyone, boys, girls? Are you sure? Negative 8 per 75, that is 1 over B, right? So B should be the other way around. Okay. So we are looking for B, image distance. So it is negative. So it is negative 75 divided 8. 9.375. Negative 9.375 centimeter. Yes. Or negative 3, negative 9.38 centimeter in two decimal places. So please be aware, we are looking for V, not 1 over V. So it is negative 9.375 cm. Okay, so that goes for the first question, A1. Okay, now find the magnification of the image. Okay, A1 find V, A2 find the magnification. So what is the magnification, students? So M. Okay, so M is V minus, sorry, V divide U. image distance divide object distance. And for M, we ignore all negative sign. Okay, so it is 9.375 divide U is 25. Okay, so by this, the linear magnification is 9.375 divide 25. So it will give you 0.375. No unit for magnification. So negative 0.375 mean less than 1. So less than 1, which means that the image has been diminished. Yes, very good. Okay, senang saja kan? Okay, now how about B? Take the characteristic of image form. So you can write number 1, it is diminished. It is virtual. Why virtual? Negative. Okay, B is negative, so it is virtual. And for convex lens, concave lens, it is always diminished and it is also upright. Okay, upright, virtual, and diminished. So the characteristic is virtual, upright, and diminished. Virtual, upright, diminished. But you please write in full. Okay, virtual, upright, diminished. Okay, easy, right? So you can try to solve for question 2, question 3, and question 4. Okay, for uji kendiri 6.4, I will share to you the full answer later on. Okay, boleh cuba sendiri eh. So anything else you would like to ask before we dismiss? So how do you think 6.4? Can you deal with it? Boys, girls, Wong Yi Ern, Goja, Eri, Yan Xin, Siu Chi, Hui Xin, Jia Yi, Ji Xiang, Jing Xiang, Ji Xiang, Sun Xiang, Yu Qian, Ji Sun, Nicholas, we still have Jin Pei here, Ong Cheng, Yu Hui, Wan Jia, Yi Ting, Man Ting, and Hong Zhe as well. So are you okay with this 6.14 lens formula? Anything else you would like to ask before we dismiss? Okay, I stop the recording first. Okay, again.